ladies and gentlemen, and thank you for coming. And it's a great pleasure of mine to play a selection of music on this quite magnificent organ. Now, because you might have noticed I nearly knocked my brains out on these pineapples on the outside of the organ, rather than get up in between each piece, which I'm sure would also be rather boring for you, I'm going to introduce things in batches. You in the hall have the program notes, but the people who are on YouTube won't have that. So I'm going to say a few words about the pieces, if you'll excuse me that luxury. I've just played the Ora Gaudiosa of Enrico Bossi, who was really the father of the Italian virtuoso school that emanated, concluded in Fernando Germani and other people later. Bossi spent quite a lot of his time traveling the world as a recitalist, and he also wrote a prolific amount of music, most of which sadly isn't played today. Ora Gaudiosa was one of five pieces that was published under the German title of Stunde der Freunde, because the edition, by being published in Germany, edition pieces felt it was better to use the German title. Another composer who went a lot to North America was the French organist Joseph Bonnet. In fact, he traveled backwards and forwards, stayed in periods in Canada and America, and then went back to France several times. And he also ended his days in Canada. Many of his organ pieces are what one might call character pieces. This is one of the lesser well-known ones. I'm going to play the Deuxième Légende, and it's a piece of very mysterious sort of beginning. The legend, I don't know what it is. He made no explanation of that. And then I'm going to follow that with another composer beginning with B, Jean Beveyer. Now, Beveyer was a pupil of Marcel Dupré, who spent most of his life working in financial worlds. He was also a very great friend and loyal friend to Dupré's great protégé, Jean de Monsieur. And this cadence was written for Jean de Monsieur's tour in America in 1953. For those of you who don't know, Jeanne de Messier was really the first great internationally famous woman. And Maurice Duroflay said that after, in comparison with de Messier, all the other French organists, of whom there were obviously a line of great organists, all played the pedals like elephants. I'm sure that's not quite true, actually, at all. But anyway, this cadence was written for de Messier's remarkable pedal technique. As you'll see, it's got all kinds of unusual effects. So, Deuxième Légende of Bonnet and Cadence of Beveyer.
Thank you.
two English pieces. Firstly, the toccata, concert toccata by Alfred Hollins. Alfred Hollins was born blind and he came down to London to study in the College for the Blind in Norwood, Norbury, I think, and spent much of his life, early life that is, playing in churches around South London, Reigate amongst them, and Red Hill, and then went to Germany to study with the great pianist Hans von Bülow, because he was also a very accomplished and active concert pianist, pardon me. In later life, or midlife rather, he was invited to go to become organist at St. George's Church in Edinburgh, where he took it upon himself to really educate the public as to the, I suppose, the mysteries and beauties of organ music and the organ. And he affectionately acquired the name of the Blind Organist of Edinburgh. His music is a reflection, I suppose, of all things that all musicians do of themselves. His music has a great radiant spirit and wonderful nature. And for those of you who haven't read it, his book, A Blind Musician Looks Back, is a real insight into someone who must have been really quite a wonderful person to know. And after that, I'd like to play you a fancy by Sir William Harris, who was one of the establishment pillars in English church music. For many years, he was the organist of St. George's, Windsor. And as it says, this is a musical trifle. So you have the concert toccata, which is a big piece, and the fancy of William Harris.
Thank you.
My next two pieces are both connected because it's pupil, teacher and pupil. The German Wilhelm Mittelschulter, after studying in Berlin, emigrated to New York, where he became an establishment figure. He played for various orchestras. He taught at what was then becoming established as the Eastman School. And he became renowned for his mastery and devotion to Bach and of his many organ works. This influence is often shown in the way he wrote for the instrument. Now this quite magnificent Passacaglia, which behind the simple name hides a really substantial and quite magnificent work, was based on the theme of Bach's name, because of course in German nomenclature of the keyboard, B is B flat, A, C, and then H, which is to us B flat, A, C, and B natural. Now this piece, this theme you'll hear woven in, it's not the theme of the Passacaglia itself, but you'll hear it all over the place in different guises, sometimes at different speeds, and it builds into something really quite extraordinary. And I hope you'll enjoy it, it's a magnificent piece. Then after that, I'd like to play you a piece by his renowned, remarkable student, Virgil Fox, the great American virtuoso who brought so many new people to the organ and was compared to Liberace, was on television shows and drew huge audiences to concerts by his great passion for the organ, but also by his knowledge and his mastery. He also swam against the tide of the time by playing a lot of music that was transcribed or that people felt was really not proper organ music, but of course he went on regardless. And I'm going to play you a very beautiful piece by William Boyce that was transcribed first of all for the piano and was in a piano volume, and then Virgil Fox transcribed the piano version, so the original title was not Ye Sweet Retreat, You Blessed Rest, but that's what Virgil Fox published it as. It's a very beautiful piece, but if you're a purist, I'm afraid you're going to find that rather indulgent.
Thank you.
any sort of sense of rest that that beautiful music has allowed us to escape into is about to be shattered. The toccata dell'actazione of Wolf Lydell is a very different sort of thing altogether. Lydell has been associated with the city of Leipzig and Weimar also for much of his life, where he has taught and played the organ in the churches and also composed. In 1979, he became so fascinated by Olivier Messiaen and Messiaen's music and whole approach to Catholicism and expression of faith through music, that he actually converted to Catholicism. Quite where that fits with this piece, I've never quite worked out. You'll soon find out why, because this piece is, I think it gets more wild as it goes along.
Thank you. That's quite hot, actually. A little encore. Well, I've just missed the hour, but you'll see what I mean in a second.